What's going on, champions? My name is Chanson Calhoun. I am a singer-songwriter and prayerfully one day a professional entertainer, full-time. Yes. Welcome to Vlogmas Day 7. It is December 7th, 2017. I wanted to get on here to talk to you about my fan base name. So, what does it mean to be a champion? I've been putting it out there on social media just to kind of see how people reacted to it. And the response has been pretty good. Like, I don't know, from people who have always supported me and my family and some friends, they really like it and they think it's catchy, and I do too. But I can't take all the credit for it. First, I'd like to talk about where it came from. Of course, Chanson is a name that I chose for myself. I legally changed my name about 2012, maybe. And it took a while for my family to kind of get used to it and to grow to it. Once they saw my passion and my love for music, they kind of caught on to calling me Chanson. So recently, probably about a few months ago, I noticed that my father, he would call me Champion. He would say, "Good morning, Champion." And at first he used to be like, "Why does he keep calling me that? I don't get it." And then it kind of grew on me, and to the point where I started to feel like a champion. Like, yes, I can conquer the day. I can go after my goals. I can do this. Like, I started to feel like that. I've been trying to figure out a way to connect to my fan base for a long time. I'm already claiming the fan base. I don't see many numbers right now, and that's because of my lack of consistency, but I'm claiming my fan base to grow. I've been trying to come up with a way to connect with my fan base for a long time now. You know, I love the Beehive, and I love the Barbs, and I love the Katy Cats and the Monsters, and I don't know, the Tay Martians. Like, I love all that. Like, I don't know, I feel like that stuff is clever. So I'm like, wow, like, they really connect to their support system. It's like a community, and it's like, wow, well, what kind of community do I want to create? So anyways, I just thought about what my dad would call me, and I decided to take out the M and put in the N. And as you can see, you know, I don't know, it just works. Like, I really, really, really like it. I love it. And so I really appreciate my dad for calling me that and making me feel powerful. So I'm like, well, I want to share this with other people. I want other people to feel like a champion. It doesn't really take much to say it. You just say champion. Like, there's no, you don't have to put an accent on it or anything. It's just champion. So yeah, I don't know. I'm really excited about it. And once I, you know, started putting it out there on social media, I'm like, okay, now I have to really define what being a champion is, and whether that's in my life and everybody else's life, I have to put a definition with it so that people understand what it is that they're calling themselves, or what, you know. And I need to understand what I'm calling myself. Champion isn't just like, oh, I'm a fan of Chanson, so I'm a champion. Like, sure, that's a part of it, but I want to define champion as someone who defeats all fear. Fear is something that has been a huge obstacle in my life and in a lot of people around me, their lives. And I don't know, fear just pisses me off. I mean, fear makes me really upset, because it keeps a lot of us from our full potential. And as a champion, I also look at conquerors, like champions, conquerors, warriors, you know, like I look at champions as like fighters, like we're fighters. What are we fighting? And the Bible says we fight not against flesh and blood. So what are we fighting against? And fear is something that you can't see. It's not something that you can hold. It's not something that you can physically beat up. But fear is something that is conquerable. You can attack fear. It just takes something deeper to attack it. So, as a champion, that's what I want to do. And that's what I want you to do. I want you to feel like you can conquer your fears. I want you to feel like you can defeat them, like, completely. And at this point in my life, I feel like I've come a long way. And I'm still growing. I'm still trying to figure out, well, what makes me a champion? What makes me able to say that, yes, I've defeated all my fears? It's almost 1 o'clock in the morning and I'm recording this video. And to be honest, I was afraid, like, you know, going into this, I know that, like, I'm literally starting from the bottom. And I don't have a problem with that because I know what has brought me to this point. And I don't even think I'm necessarily starting from the bottom, but it feels like the bottom. And it's always going to feel like that when you're starting. But I was always told to look at what you have. Look at what's in your hand. And use that. I got a phone. I got some resources. Some friends who know, you know, how to do some awesome work. I have God on my side. I have a supportive family. Things that you can't put a price on. You take those things and you utilize them. You utilize the crap out of them. And once you know what you have, you take what you have, you utilize it, and you keep going. You know, there was a time where I definitely, I don't want to say stopped, but I definitely took a break. Took a pause, took a light, let's call it a life moment. I took a life moment to grow, to hurt, to cry, to humble myself. Really, God humbled me to the point where, like, I've become a completely different person. I used to feel like my city owed me something. I used to feel like the music world owed me something. I used to feel like, I don't know, like I deserve more than what I was getting. And that's before I even learned about really who I was. I didn't know who I was. I didn't know what my sound was. I didn't know what I wanted to put out into the world. I had no clue. And I'm still learning that. And it's okay. I heard somebody say, you know, it never says how long it takes you to get your degree on your degree. You got a degree just like everybody else. Just because it took you 6 years, 4 years, 3 years, whatever. Same thing with any goal or any accomplishment. It doesn't matter how long it takes. As long as you're doing it, as long as you keep pushing. this isn't all about me. I'm just grateful to be in this position, and I love being used by God. Like all this, this is God right here. This is God, all of it. And I'm just blessed to be in the position to be used in order to help somebody else feel good about themselves. And if this stuff helps somebody, like, that's what it's all about. I just want to help somebody. So, what does it mean to be a champion? It means defeating all your fears, resting in the knowledge of, I have a purpose. I was created, and I'm happy about that. I'm excited about that. I'm a champion. I can conquer my goals. I can do all things. That's what a champion is. And I just so happen to be the representative, because I feel like it's my calling. I feel like it's my purpose. And no one can stand in the way of that. And I'm not even saying me. Like, I'm not going to push you out the way. That's God's job. I'm just going to do what I do. Either you're going to be here with us, or you're not. So, I believe in you. You are a champion. We are champions. And I don't know, I feel like once this music comes out and once the vision just keeps spilling out of me, I feel like it's gonna be evident. It's gonna be beautiful. And I appreciate all the support and all the love. I thank God for you all. Thank God for 100 subscribers. We hit 100 a couple days ago. Share, like, subscribe, everything. Follow me on all social media at Chance and Calhoun. I just wanted to get on here and kind of explain what I'm trying to build and the vision that I feel like I've been given. And I'm so excited about it. And I don't know. Let me know what you think. What does being a champion mean to you? And don't be shy. Yeah. Thanks, guys.